So yesterday, Axios released the video of the interview with reporter Jonathan Swan and Donald Trump. The thing immediately went viral. Most people who watched this were kind of shocked that Donald Trump was this callous and this uninformed. But in case you haven't seen it, here's a quick highlight of that particular segment. Here it is.
You test, some kid has even just a little runny nose, it's a case. And then you report many cases. So we look like we have more cases than massive countries like China, which, by the way, doesn't report, as you know.
Well, I don't put any stock in China's figures.
The point is, because we are so much better at testing than any other country in the world, we show more cases.
The figure I look at is death. And death is going up now. Okay, and it's 1,000 a day.
If you look at death...
Yeah, it's going up again.
Let's look.
Daily death.
Take a look at some of these charts.
I'd love to.
We're going to look.
Let's look.
And if you look at death...
Yeah. It started to go up again.
One. Well, right here, the United States is lowest in numerous categories. We're lower than the world.
Lower than the world?
Lower than Europe.
In what? In what?
Take a look. Right here. Here's case death.
Oh, you're doing death as a proportion of cases. I'm talking about death as a proportion of population. That's where the U.S. is really bad.
Well,
much worse than South Korea, Germany, etc.
You can't do that.
You have to go by where...
Look, here is the United States. You have to go by the cases. The cases...
Why not
death.
As a proportion of population?
When we have somebody... What it says is when you have somebody that has it, where there's a case, the people that live those cases.
It's surely a relevant statistic to say if the U.S. has X population and X percentage of death of that population versus South Korea.
No, because you have to go by the cases.
First and foremost, I would actually like to point out that the way Jonathan Swan just handled that interview is how every single person that interviews anyone ever, that is how you do it. I cannot stress that enough. This is what we've been waiting for, not just with Donald Trump, but really for any politician to just straight up call them out for their BS to their faces. No fear, no quibbling around it, no like, well, actually, I think... No, Jonathan Swan was just like, what? What the hell are you talking about? No, that's not true. That is how reporters, well, interviewers, that is how interviewers should be. You don't have to be combative, but when somebody says something you know is not true, don't dance around the issue. Pull a Jonathan Swan and straight up say, what are you talking about? Because that's not real. I loved that. And the second thing I loved the most was that Donald Trump kind of seemed like a little kid, right? He's got his little charts, he's got his pictures, and he's flipping through them, and he's like, oh, you're not going to get me. I've got this chart here. And you look at my chart. And even that, Jonathan Swan's like, yeah, no, that's what you're saying doesn't necessarily match this. But here's the overall takeaway, right? It's not just that Donald Trump looked like a fool. It wasn't just that Donald Trump told Swan that, no, you can't measure that metric because that makes us look bad. The fact is that Donald Trump has, and this is what he proved in that interview, he's managed to delude even himself about how bad the pandemic is. That's how dangerous this situation that we are currently living in is. Even Trump believes his own lies at this point. That's the danger. That's what puts us all in jeopardy right now. Because he's trying to put a positive spin on it. He told Fox and Friends just this morning that I think I've done a great job with it. We've done a good job with Corona, he said. Because he, honest to God, believes that he has. He believes that we don't have as many people dying as we actually do. Because when you look at his math versus the other math, hey, it looks great, right? And the best way to talk about that, and this is kind of what they were debating in that interview there, was that if you have a country that has 100 new cases and five of those people die, the mortality rate is 5%. You know, 5% of people with it die. Whereas if you have a country like the United States that has 100,000 new cases and 1,000 people die every day, well, that's technically only 1%. So yes, our death rate is better, but we also lost 1,000 people. They lost 5 people. And that's what Swan was trying to point out. You can use these numbers that are in fact accurate, but they are deceptive. They do not paint the full picture. And it's very clear that this is what Donald Trump's handlers in the White House have been doing to him. They've been saying, look, 5% of people who get it in this country are dying. 1% of our people are dying. But you have to look at it, as Swan points out, as an overall percentage of population, in which case the United States is going up. We are having the equivalent of a 9/11 every 2.5 days with the total number of people dying. This isn't getting better. And to be honest, I don't think it's ever going to get better as long as we have an incompetent buffoon serving in the White House who chooses to believe his own lies that we've got this whole thing under control. We don't. He doesn't. And he likely never will.